To start creating Ionic applications, the first thing we need to do is to install the Ionic CLI. For that, we type npm install -g for globally Ionic/CLI. Once the CLI is installed, we are going to create our first application typing Ionic Start. Then it's going to ask you a few questions about our application. First, we're going to pick the framework we're going to use. In our case, it's Angular. Then we're going to give the application a name. In our case, it's Pocket Party Planner. And then we're going to pick the starting template we're going to use. In our case, it's just a blank template. Once we do that, it's going to ask you if we want to integrate with Capacitor. Right now, we're not going to do that. And then we just let install all the dependencies. Now that our application is generated and all the dependencies are installed, we are going to open our application with our preferred text editor. In my case, I'm going to use Visual Studio Code. When we open the application, we can see all of the files that it generated for us. In our case, it generated the TypeScript configuration files, the package.json files that handle all the dependencies, and more important, the angular.json file that handles all of the build commands for our application. It also has a source folder. This is where the actual source code of the application will live. We have an app folder that will have all of our components, services, directives. We have an assets folder that will have all of our static assets, like images, icons, and things like that. And we also have an environments folder that will have all of the configuration for the environments we will deploy to. We also have the theme folder and the global.scss file. These are for styling purposes.